I'm Matt Harrington, and today's Toolbox Talk revolves around the most common problem folks have with setting our EFCO walls is the setting of the top yokes. Top yokes come in TY2, 3, 4, and 7. That designation just describes how long the top yokes are depending on the thickness of the wall. The top yokes are used to take the place of a top tie. EFCO's rugged ties and top yokes keep a wall from spreading apart, but not necessarily from collapsing inwards. What that does is it allows the top tie to be about 6 foot down from the top of your concrete wall pour. The top yokes are designed where they have four holes on one end that are 1.5 inches centers, and then the field holes that are all at 2 inches on center. What that allows is for you to be able to hit any wall dimension at 1/2 inch increments. The way we determine what set of holes to use on our top yoke is, first of all, we have 1.5 inches from the center of this first hole to the edge of the super stud, 4.5 inches for the thickness of the form, plus 12 inches for the thickness of the wall, plus another 4.5 for the form over here, and another 1.5 inches from the edge of the super stud to the center of that first hole over there. So if you add up 12 inches for the wall, 4.5 plus 4.5 for the form, 1.5 and 1.5 for the super stud, that puts us right at 24 inches. From there, what you want to do is look for which set of holes corresponds to 24 inches on your top yoke. This first one you can see, it hits right in the middle right there, that's not going to work. Your second one in, that one's still not quite good. Your third hole in right there, center to center, 24 inches. If you were to go on and look at this last hole, you can see it almost hits that hole, but what it's probably gonna do is give you a wall that's about 1/4 inch wider. That's why it's critical to lay it out and see which one corresponds and hits directly at 24 inches on center. The first side of our wall has been flown and set into place. It's been anchored down at the bottom. The pipe braces are set and the wall's been plumbed. All of our blockouts have been properly installed. It's always good to set the top yoke immediately after the bottom tie, because at that point any of the remainder middle ties will not be over tightened, and it'll allow you to push the wall in or out in order to get it easily installed. When you fly your second side up, you always install your yoke either on top of your form or hooked on your super stud wherever you have more room. Snug of a wrench and your top yokes are set. After the bottom tie has been installed and your top yoke has been installed at that time, you can go ahead and cut the crane loose and then fill in all the remainder ties whenever it's convenient. A good double check is to go back after all the top yokes have been set and look across and make sure that all the bolts are in the same holes on all the top yokes on each side of your super studs. What this will do is guarantee that your wall is a uniform thickness from one end to the other. If you have any questions about setting your top yokes or gang forms, contact your EFCO field supervisor and look us up on YouTube.